of you with my love and blessings. Shri Brahmotsavam, the Subramanya's Skanda Shashti Utsavam is beginning. This is one of the very well-known popular vrata observed in South India, the most popular vrata observed in South India. From the young age, I never used to miss this vrata. Today, as part of the first day of the Brahmotsavam, Subramanya is gracing on the golden peacock, Swarna Mayura Vahana. Now I can see some more cities joining. St. Louis, Tirumala, Indrani, New Jersey, Monterrey, Mexico, today is the day Devi sends Subramanya with the weapon, the pierce, with her whole energy as pierce. She sends him to kill the demons. So from Kailasha, Subramanya comes on the peacock. And many parts of the country, today also we continue to celebrate Diwali. Diwali is celebrated in some parts of the country today. San Jose, we have a Diwali today. 36 items are offered as Naivedyam and Kali Puja is done. Blessings. Blessings to all you guys. Let me start today's satsang. I'm going to expand today on power of completion. Please understand, our muscles carry memory. Memory and memories. Carry memory, you live a beautiful, blissful. If your muscles carry memories, you are in a mess. Listen. If your muscle carries a memory, you will live a blissful life. If it carries memories, you are in a mess. The difference, when there is too many memories sitting on the muscle, creating a stress, complication, confusion, incompletions. It's almost like even to make one small decision, you have to go through the whole parliament. It is literally democracy. Please understand, democracy is great for a country, but for a body, you cannot have democracy. Just to move a right hand, just to move a right hand, the information as to the file should be prepared, a detailed resolution, and it goes to the brain. Then liver supports it, liver supports, brain does not support, heart vetoes, and kidney says no. After all this discussion, you have to move the right hand. Will you move ever? Democracy is not for
body.
So please understand, democracy is great as a country. To run a country, democracy is great because multiple point of views need to be considered, because everyone's life is affected by the decisions made. But as far as your body is concerned, it's only your life. It's just your life. But even in movements of the body, if you start doing democracy, never ever any movements will happen. If you are filled with too many incompletions and memories, this is what exactly happens. Most of the time, you really do not know what you want. How many of you feel, the whole problem in my life is I do not know what I want? God, 90% of the hall. Remaining 10% do not even know whether they want. They know what they want or they don't know what they want. Even that they do not know. I tell you, identity crisis is always one of the biggest problem of human beings. Identity crisis, don't know what we want in the life. Don't know what we are doing in the life. If you don't know what you want in the life, you are just waiting to die. Be very clear. You are not living, you are waiting to die. Waiting to die is not living. Many of you, if you look inside, you are just waiting to die. You don't have the courage to commit suicide, so you are just dragging your days, time. Please understand, that is not life. You need to get it. You need to understand. When you bring completion, you reduce the number of thoughts precedes before a conclusion arrives. It is like you reduce the screaming and shouting happening inside you. The unparliamentary parliament which you are running inside. The sound of that reduces. The sound comes down if you do completion. Please listen. If you come to the decision without a thought, you are living in the space of intuition. If you come to the decision after multiple thoughts, it is ignorance. If you come to the decision after one clear flow of thoughts, it is called intelligence. If you come to the decision without any thought, it is called intuition. Please understand. I really tell you, completion is equivalent to a inner cleansing. All your muscle memories comes to peace and rests in peace. And I also wanted you to know, I strongly discourage any of these bodily work getting done by the people whose muscle memory is incomplete. For example, do not get this massages done for you, whether it's Ayurvedic or Western type, whatever massage, do not allow any massages, because when two bodies strongly meet heavily, the transmission of muscle memory will happen, more damage for you in the long run than help. The best massage, I tell you, sit and do completion, all the stress in the muscles will be removed, they will melt down. When they melt down, the relaxation you feel, I tell you, that is the best massage. The problem is, it takes little time and your effort, which you have a deep hatred towards you creating something for you. You want everything to be done by somebody else, and you will just come and occupy. Some of the best parts of my life, I still remember, from 2000 to 2005, I can say. Of course, it's not that after that I am suffering or anything. I'm enjoying the whole life. But that 5 years, I can say, best part. Because in that 5 years, mostly, till this Bidhi Kitchen started, mostly, I was cooking my own food. I was building my own house. So everything was filled by my muscle memory and bio memory. I tell you, as much as you can, do not allow anybody to work on your body. Because a deep touch can transmit incompletion. Completion. Silence bring tremendous peace into your whole muscle memory and bio memory. It can really, really, really bring a new understanding and bliss in your life. Because every incompletion stored in different parts of your body, see, that is like a sleeping volcano, but living. All the incompletions in your muscle memory is like a sleeping volcano. Any time it will erupt out and start, whoosh, you are in depression. There is no big reason required when that agitation, boiling, distress, doubt, anger going on. Even a simple instruction from mother, simple instruction from father. If you already are, you are angry with your father and mother, these fellows are constantly controlling me. These fellows are constantly agitating me. These fellows are constantly irritating me. Your mother may give a very simple instruction. Hey, don't drink coffee in the night. You will not sleep well. You will be rolling in the bed. That's it. It's a simple, beautiful instruction to protect your health. That's it. Your kundalini will happen in the wrong direction. Yesterday, I was telling the few participants during Diwali celebration, please don't go to the burst crackers, especially the participants from different countries, because you do not know the Indian cracker, I tell you. No, really. No, you do not know Indian crackers. And I am responsible for your health. You understand this, it as fireworks. This is not fireworks. You should know there's a big difference between fireworks and crackers. This is a crude, I can't describe it for you. I'm so happy. Yesterday is the first Diwali. We did not have any accident. Now really, in this large crowd, yesterday from the beginning I was very careful. I told even the Swamis, I come with chappal, don't put fire when somebody is behind. Have enough distance. I told everyone, please come with your footwear and maintain a lot of distance. I also selected the huge area, vast area, where there are no huts. First Diwali, Laughing Temple was burnt in the ashram. Still I remember, the Laughing Temple is the first building we constructed. After the construction, first time when I observed Diwali, it got burnt, but not fully, partially, but immediately it rained, because we didn't have water. It just rained and whole fire got put off. So from that time, only yesterday is the first Diwali, we did not have any accidents. It is just simple security measures, safety precaution. See, we always jump in the enthusiasm. Come on, why footwear? Why? What is the wrong? I know, I'm a child or what? I know the cracker. No. You don't know. Even the fellow who made, he doesn't know. See, yesterday, a few crackers, which were supposed to give only the light, started bursting. I tell you, memory stored in your muscle also acts like an Indian crackers. You do not know whether it is going to be bus or damal. You do not know when it is going to do what, how it is going to respond. You do not know the way it is going to respond. If you are having a teenage kid, please understand, having muscle memory is equivalent to a teenage kid, because you don't know what it will do when. If you put the kid on the Gurukul, that is completion. That is like completion. You are free from it. Then now it is my work. Now really, please understand. The muscle memories are such, it makes your whole life constantly to be on a crisis management mode. Suddenly one part of you creates some fire and you go and put it off. By the time you put the fire off and wash your whole body, the other side fire is off, on. You run there. Life becomes almost like a crisis management. Constantly, everywhere, crisis. Crisis in the relationship. By the time you heal that, crisis in the health. By the time you heal that, crisis in the wealth. By the time you heal that, crisis in the mental health, depression. But you heal that, then again starts the relationship problem. It is like your whole life is in the crisis management mode. How many of you feel my whole life is really in the crisis management mode? Please understand, because too many memories sitting inside muscles. I tell you, completion. If you don't know what is completion, even if you just sit every night before falling asleep and even think whatever has happened in your life, you will catch the exact process of completion. See, the process of completion is a knack. You won't get it by instruction. Of course, I can give instruction, but you will get it only when you start living. For example, yesterday my swamis, they all lifted weight. I can give instruction about weightlifting. Will they get it? They will get it only when they do it step by step. I was really surprised. These guys lifted 135 kgs. God. And all of them are Niraharis. Many of them are Niraharis. Double their average body weight. I'm so happy that please understand, weightlifting is a spiritual quality. I wanted you to know, when you do all this heavy workout, your muscles get built. You can actually program and build your muscles in a new way. Especially the Swamis, they don't have any other reason to build the muscles. Their only reason is the spiritual ideas and spiritual truths and spiritual living, that's all. Normal people who build muscles, who build body, even those people, enlightenment is easy for them, because when you build the body and muscle, you will have the confidence you can do anything with your body. You will have that confidence. I tell you, that confidence will help you in a very big way to achieve completion and enlightenment. And I strongly promote, support all the activities you working on your body, like weightlifting, bodybuilding, everything. And I very strongly condemn, denounce, request you not to indulge in any activities where other person works on your body, like whether it is a massage or fighting. Even the fighting, wrestling. See, martial arts, body doesn't touch each other. If the bodies don't touch each other, that is okay. Things like wrestling, where the bodies touch each other, should be avoided. Actually, if you want to win in wrestling, I can give you a very simple tip. Go with a lot of incompletions related to the body and touch that fellow. That's all. And after that, manage 10 minutes. In 10 minutes, you will be tired. Create a lot of incompletions about your hand. My hand is not doing well. It's not well. It's not looking good. It's so small. It's not strong. Create a lot of incompletions about hand. This line is not right. This line is not right. This is ugly. That is crazy. And touch the other fellow. That's all. And wait for 10 minutes. After touching, just somehow manage for 10 minutes. The fellow will be out. Because through hands, the muscle memory gets transmitted very powerfully. Whenever you see a person who lives in the space of completion, never miss touching his feet or the hand. Because that is a space through which the energy gets transmitted, the muscle memories, biomemory, bioenergy gets transmitted. Completion, completion, completion. Yesterday, all of you are initiated into the science of completion with yourself. From today, we are going to really, really enter into the deeper levels of completion in the inner awakening. Third day. Today is only third day. Wow. Today, we will identify your root patterns and complete, 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 complete. From today, your Skanda Shashti starts. Subramanya has to kill all the incompletion demons. Vivekananda used to say, muscles of iron, bone of steel, he says, the person whose body is strong will always be doing less mistakes and he will be more integrated. I did not believe first when I read that. I thought, how can body and mind be connected? Because I'm a great Vedanti, at least I was thinking. I was a great Vedanti from the beginning. I was thinking, oh, this Vivekananda and all modern day saints. But only when I started living his words, I realize the truth. His words are 200% right. I tell you, just build your body, you will stop falling into depression. So much your being will start getting centered into the integrity. So much your being will start getting centered into authenticity. That is why I was so happy yesterday when my Swamis did the weightlifting. I was very happy they even chose this item as part of their demonstration. Because I wanted the world to know that I am encouraging all this. Once I myself lifted for 10 seconds 300 kg. I just raised the kundalini of the body heavily, almost on the verge of the nirvikalpa samadhi. In that I tried, I saw 300 kg 10 seconds. Because when the kundalini is raised, you will really be able to lift the weight. Actually, I was doing research on how the weightlifting can be added into yoga, because I strongly feel the original Nathapantis, the Natha Sampradaya yogis, used weights in their akada practices, in their physical training. The Nathapandis used the wooden logs. In north, Agoris used the wood and stone, other weights, heavy weights, to train their body. So weightlifting is not something new to the Indian tradition. It is not from Western tradition. It is from our tradition, because when you add the weight, the flexibility of the body increases. Above all, the breathing becomes very deep. So I was doing research on how that can be added into the physical yoga and fitness programs. Every night completion, every morning heavy weightlifting and yoga. I tell you, just these two will make you enlightened. Because every night completion will lead to Vedic mind, every morning heavy yoga will lead to yogic body. And these two will take care, whole day you live enlightened living, that's all. You don't need any other spiritual practice. Really, I'm telling you. Morning, heavy yoga, heavy weightlifting, like your whole body should really sweat. That kind of a yoga and weightlifting. After that, you should take bath in a water body, not just in a water bucket. In a water body in which at least 100 times more than your blood volume, water is there. Usually your body carries 5 to 10 liter water based on the size. 100 times more. At least the water body should be 1000 liter. Even if it's a 1000 liter Syntex tank, it is okay. But you should be able to get into that and take bath. It should be a water body. If it is 1000 times more than your blood volume, best. Because when you get into that kind of a water body, the whole body will experience the water energy rejuvenation. And the whole body will have a new alignment of prana. That is why in those days, to learn singing, you have to go and stand in the neck level water. Because the kind of a unique prana alignment happens in the water body due to the pressure of the water body. heavy yoga in the morning, deep completion in the night is enough for the enlightened living. Today I wanted to declare this. This too should be compulsory for anybody who considers me as your guru. Anybody who thinks you are following me or you want to follow me, this too is a compulsory. This too is a must. Now whatever I said earlier, you can amend it now with this too. Everything can be amended. Nitya Dhyan, Nitya Kriya, everything you can amend. But catch this too. Morning yoga, heavy yoga, it can even be 40 minutes, 42 minutes is more than enough, or maximum 1 hour, that's enough. 21 minutes, good, 42 minutes, best, that's all. No need for more than 1 hour. Night, same. When you start the completion, start for 42 minutes. After that, you yourself will see nothing much. There's no incompletions. So 21 minutes is more than enough. When you see that, just complete with 21 minutes. But always sleep in the space of completion. If you have a dreamless sleep, I guarantee you will have birthless life. If you have dream-free sleep, you will have birth-free, death-free life. That's all. Because even to have dream, you need incompletion. If you don't have incompletions even to have dream, how will you have incompletions to have one more body? So whether you are going to have a body or not is going to be decided only based on whether you are having your dreams in the night or not. While you sleep, if you have dreams, you are going to have body after death, unless Master interferes and relieves you, liberates you. If you don't have dreams, be assured you are already liberated and you are going to be liberated once you leave the body completely. So every night, 21 minutes completion good, 42 minutes best. Every morning, 21 minutes yoga good, 42 minutes best. From Garanda Samhita, I am creating a new sequence of 84 asanas which will be released in IA level 4. This sequence will be the best of yoga. Understand? Best of yoga. Already the work is on. 32 I have aligned and made it into a sequence. Now expanding to 84. Garanda Samhita Mahadeva gives 84 asanas as the complete yoga. In that same sequence as Mahadeva gives, you will all be learning. Once the whole thing is ready, I'll put it in the YouTube freely. Anybody can download and practice. I am actually reading the original verses and fine-tuning the postures. For example, in the Dhanurasana, you should not be just touching with your finger the feet, you should be holding Dhanur. The rope does not touch the other end, it is tied. So this fine, intricate details of each asana, I'm reading the original sutra and aligning. My yoga is also working on demonstrating it. Soon you will have a my yoga's presentation of these 84 asanas into the YouTube. This will be called as Nityananda Yoga. These 84 asanas should be called as Nityananda Yoga or Nitya Yoga, whatever name. This should be called as Nitya Yoga. The postures themselves, by their own way of doing, the weightlifting is inbuilt into that. Only thing, you will be using the traditional weights. It's called Karana Katte. Means the Natha yogis are called Karana yogis. See, they will have a huge earrings on the ear to remind themselves to be in the space of listening. All their scriptures are listening based. So the wooden stick or the heavy wood they use for weightlifting yoga is called Karanakatte. In course of time it got turned into Karlakatte. So we will be using all those traditional weights. There are clear definition what weight it should be when you start. The Natha yogis does not believe having equal weights in both the hands. They say that one side you should have a different weight. If you are a male, your left should always have more weight. If you are a female, your right should always have a more weight. So they have a clear proportion. Long before I wanted to develop this science and evolve it, unfortunately time, now only I am bringing it to a shape. This IA level 4, I will be launching it. If you can participate IA level 4, great. Even if you miss IA level 4, don't worry. Immediately it will be available in the YouTube. You can start practicing. Knowledge is free. Knowledge is free. And I will also be giving you a reference of everything to a minute detail to prove the authenticity. With this, I'll move to the next segment of the morning satsang. Nirahara Samyama. Because of Skanda Sashti, almost everyone will be doing Nirahara Samyama. So we had a break in Nirahara Samyama yesterday due to Diwali, but we will start today directly the second level. We will start today directly second level. From today, next 7 days, it is Nirahara Samyama level 2 and Skanda Shashti Vrata, both. Skanda Shashti is the time people do fasting and do completion. It's a very auspicious time and energy. Actually, from Diwali to Purnima, this 15 days is a celebration time, because today Skanda Shashti starts for next 6 days, and 6th day itself, the Arunachalishwara, the Brahmotsavam, Kartike Deepam. In north they celebrate as Dev Deepavali. In south they celebrate as Deepam. In Varanasi, the coming Purnima day, they will light the Moksha Deepam, means in the long bamboos they will light Deepams and hold it up. Same way, in Thiruvannamalai, on the temple tower, on the hill, not only in Thiruvannamalai, whole south, on all the hilltops they will light the lamp. That is also called moksha deepam. So this whole 15 days, Dev Deepavali means, see, for us 1 year is 1 day for devatas. So naturally, at least 15 day they need to celebrate 1 day. We celebrate 1 day Diwali. For them, they need one paksha as Diwali. The whole 15 days this month, sorry, this 15 days from Amavasya to Purnima is called Dev Deepavali. Diwali for gods. Paksha is 15 days. So, this whole 15 days we will celebrate for Nirahara and completion. We will do the completion. Whoever wants to do Nirahara, you can do Nirahara. Nirahara is option, completion is compulsion. So, please sit straight. Cognize, you have become Bidhi Kalpa Vriksha. Inhale through both the nostrils and the mouth simultaneously, as slowly as possible. Hold as long as you can comfortably. Exhale through both the nostrils as slowly as possible. Do this kriya for next 21 minutes. I bless you all with my integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching. Let you all radiate health, bliss and enlightenment by producing the energy directly from space. Namah Shivaya. Live, express, radiate, share and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda
Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.